We want to simplify the imaginary unit I raised to powers. To simplify these, we're going to use the fact that I squared is equal to negative 1. And when simplifying these, they will all simplify to positive or negative 1 or positive or negative I. And we know they're simplified when they fit the form of a complex number or a number in the form of a plus or minus bi. So the main thing to remember here is if it's simplified, we can't have I raised to a power other than 1. So to simplify I to the fifth, we want to ask ourselves how many factors of I squared are in I to the fifth. Well, I squared to the second is equal to I to the fourth, so we'd still have one extra factor of I. So to help us determine this exponent here, what we could do is take the given exponent of 5 and divide by 2. Notice that 5 divided by 2 would be 2. 2 times 2 is 4 with a remainder of 1. So this number here tells us the exponent on I to the second. And because we have a remainder of 1, this tells us we'll have one more factor of I left over. And now we can just substitute negative 1 for I squared. We would have negative 1 to the second times I. Negative 1 raised to an even power is going to be positive 1. Positive 1 times I is equal to I. So this simplifies to I. Next we have I to the 12th. Again, we want to determine how many factors of I squareds do we have in I to the 12th. So we could take 12 and divide by 2, and that's equal to 6 with a remainder of 0. Notice if we raise I squared to the 6th power, this is still I to the 12th, and now we can substitute again negative 1 for I squared, so we have negative 1 raised to the 6th power, and again because the exponent is even, this is going to be equal to positive 1. Notice in this case, we didn't have any leftover factors of I because I was raised to an even power. Next we have I to the 63rd power. Again, we want to know how many factors of I squareds are in I to the 63rd. So to help us figure this out, we'll take 63 and divide it by 2. 2 goes into 6 3 times. 2 goes into 3 1 time. So notice how there are 31 2's in 63 with the remainder of 1. So this would be I squared to the 31st power. This would be I to the 62nd. And we have one more factor of I because we have I to the 63rd. And now we substitute negative 1 for I squared. In this case, if we raise negative 1 to an odd power, this would be negative 1. Negative 1 times I is negative I. And again, this was equal to positive 1 here. And then for our last example, we have I raised to the 54th power. So now we want to ask how many factors of I squareds are in I to the 54th. So we can take 54 and divide by 2. There are 2 2's in 5, and there are 7 2's in 14. Notice our remainder is 0, which will always be the case when the original exponent is even. So this tells us that there are 27 factors of I squared in I to the 54th, and there are 0 factors of I left over. So now we just substitute negative 1 for I squared. Negative 1 raised to an odd power is going to be equal to negative 1. So notice how when the exponent is even in these two cases, the result will be either positive 1 or negative 1. And when we have I raised to an odd power, the result will be either positive I or negative I. These are the only four cases when simplifying I raised to a power. I hope you found this helpful.